Hello everybody, welcome to Mission for Perfect Study channel. Friends, in this video we are going to discuss 10 best multiple choice questions for CTET examination 2019. All these questions I have taken from the CTET examination question paper 2018. Before this video I have uploaded a video in which I included 10 questions. Okay, so this is the another 10 questions that I am including here from the section Child Development and Pedagogy. After this video, friends, there will be more videos in this series. So watch all these videos for your best preparations. Watching these videos from beginning to end will boost your preparation level. Also, friends, the theoretical things, all the theoretical things and all the chapter wise details will be separately updated and uploaded in form of videos before your examination. So I request you to subscribe this channel Mission for Perfect Study and press the bell icon so that you can get instant notifications whenever we upload any video relevant to CTET examination on our channel. Okay, so let us go ahead very quickly and see the questions which were asked in CTET examination 2018. All these questions will be just like a model question paper for all of you. If you candidate know the answer or reply of these questions, please write your reply in the comment section and check how much preparation you have done up to now, what is your preparation level. Okay, so the first question here is children acquire general roles through all of the following except. You have given four options. You have to tell that out of these four options, okay, three acquire gender roles. Because of three, children acquire gender roles, but there is one out of these because of which children do not acquire gender roles. So media, socialization and culture, these are the three things by which children acquire gender roles. Okay, whenever a child becomes socialized or any cultural activity a child participate into, or in the media, all everywhere a child can acquire gender roles. But in case of tutoring or teaching or learning process, child will not acquire gender roles. So this is the correct option for this question. Next one is, one of the critics of standardized test has been that there is a specific type of question paper, specific type of test that is called standardized test. Okay, you can see the detailed information, detailed things regarding standardized test in NIOS book or your DLED, BLED book. Okay, the books which you have studied in your diploma course of education. Okay, you can get the standardized test, everything about this. So you have to pick out one which is the critics of this standardized test. They represent largely the mainstream culture and are therefore biased. They largely represent mainstream culture and are therefore biased. So this is the biggest critics of standardized test. I hope that you have studied much more about what exactly are the standardized test, and you must have been understanding that this option is the best option for this question. Next question is, the theory of multiple intelligence says that multiple intelligence, as the name itself suggests, that intelligence can be of several kinds. So this is the correct option for this answer. Teacher can utilize both assessment for learning and assessment of learning. Assessment for learning means a child is learning. So how, what are the situations in which a child can learn? And assessment of learning is something that the assessment of what the child has learned up to now. So both are the different things. So the teacher can utilize these two things, these two parameters, to check what in the following. know the children's progress and achievement level. So yes, this is the correct option. The teacher utilizes these two parameters to check the children's progress and achievement level. Okay, so the correct option is this one. Which one of the following is not related to continuous and comprehensive evaluation? As I already told you in the syllabus, when I was telling you the syllabus, I told you that this topic is very important. Continuous and comprehensive evaluation. You will see the questions of a question from this topic in CTET examination or in any teacher eligibility test, be it be from any state, or in KVS Kendri Vidyalaya Sangathan examination, Navodaya Vidyalaya examination, DSSB, UP, anywhere. You can get the questions based on this topic definitely. Continuous and comprehensive evaluation. So you have to pick out the following which is not related. It means three are related to CCE and one of the following is not related to CCE. It has been mandated by the Right to Education Act of India. It is an integral part of teaching learning process. Yes, it is an integral part of teaching learning process. This is correct. It focuses on children's achievement in different learning areas. Yes, it is also correct. This is also correct that it has been mandated by Right to Education Act of India. And last one, it is useful to label children as slow, poor and intelligent. So this is not correct, as the statement itself clears. Statement number 4 says that it is useful to label children as slow, poor. It means in a class, if you segregate children that this much students are slower, this much students are poor and this much students are intelligent. So you are labeling students according to their performance or their background, which is not acceptable in case of progressive education, in case of inclusive education. So the thing, continuous and comprehensive evaluation, is meant to eradicate such practices, okay, to labeling the children in such type of scenarios. You can level the children in other ways, but not like this. So this option is the correct answer for this question. Next one is giftedness is in children can be attributed to giftedness in children. A child can be a gifted child. That can be attributed from which of the following options? An interplay between heredity and environment, a resource-rich environment, successful parents, or a disciplined routines. So giftedness can occur only if the heredity and environment. I have already told you in the first video of this series that in the development of children, heredity and environment plays a vital role. So if both are balanced and have a good effect, then a child may be gifted child. So this option is the correct answer for this question. Next one is children coming from socio-economically disadvantaged backgrounds need a classroom environment. Those students who are coming from a socio-economically disadvantaged backgrounds, they need such type of a classroom environment which teaches them a good behavior. It's not that much correct. Values and uses their cultural and linguistic knowledge. Yes, it's absolutely correct. That classroom environment which values and uses their cultural and linguistic knowledge so that they can feel comfortable in the classroom. Their socio-economically conditions, backgrounds may be not very good, but if a school or if a classroom values their cultural and linguistic knowledge, they will feel much more comfortable and the learning process will be progressive. Okay, so this option is the correct option. The intervention needed for creative and talented children in the classroom rests on. You know, in the classroom, there are many students who are very creative and very talented and some are not that much creative or talented. So what are the interventions needed for creative and talented children, those candidates, those students who are very talented or creative? So what interventions are needed in the classroom? Use of customized and stimulating instructional methods by the teacher. Yet it's correct. Use of customized and stimulating instructional methods by a teacher. A teacher can use such stimulating instructional method so that the child's inner thoughts can be open. The child can be open-minded and think about surroundings and can himself do something, you know, practically, can be a practical student, not just theoretical. Rest of the other options, like giving extra time to them. If a teacher is giving extra time to a creative or talented person, that will not be that much beneficial. A teacher should give some responsibility to that students to learn practically. Okay, that is why it is here that stimulating instructional methods should be adopted by the teacher. Next one is, which one of the following ways is not a suitable way to help hyperactive children learn? Those children who are hyperactive, very active children. So out of these four options, which option is not a successful way to deal with the hyperactive children? Breaking up a task to small manageable segments. It is, if you break a task in small manageable segments, that will be very much effective and beneficial for hyperactive children. Offering alternative ways of learning, this is also correct. Including physical activity in their daily schedule, it is also correct. Reprimanding them often for being restless. You cannot reprimand or scold a child for anything. If you scold a child, because nowadays the education is completely child-centered, you should not demoralize children by scolding or reprimanding because of their mistakes. You can remove the problems in the child with the help of some psychological steps, psychological treatment, or the other, using other teaching methodologies. You can remove those mistakes or those drawbacks from the student, but you cannot reprimand or scold that student for anything like that. Okay, it's completely unacceptable. So the correct option for this question is reprimanding them often for being restless. Next question, patterns of divergent thinking. Identify children who are patterns of divergent thinking. In what type of students we can see patterns of divergent thinking? Divergent means something which is originating from one source and going to different ways, means unlimited scope. There are unlimited scope of thinking. So it is the creative students, the creative children, those children who are creative in nature, they have divergent thinking patterns. So the correct option for this question is option number 3. So friends, this was all, and I hope that you have enjoyed this video, and such type of questions will be asked in your examination. So prepare accordingly and subscribe Mission for Perfect Study channel for more videos and updates. Thank you and have a great day.